In the eye of the storm, you remain in control. Swallowing, I can barely take a breath. And when addiction steals my baby girl, and there's nothing I can do, my only hope is to trust you. I trust you, Lord. In the eye of the storm,
there seems to be no way. God made a way. Just going through Nevada right now. Saw some water and haven't showered in. I showered yesterday, but not today. So,
I'm gonna read
Psalm 23 for the glory of God. It's so powerful. Hallelujah. It relates a lot to where I'm at right now. So, Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd. I should not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yeah, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they keep me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Psalm 23. It relates a lot to where I'm at right now. And who my shepherd is. And who leads this vessel. So the Lord is my shepherd, I should not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. So I'm right here, next to this water. So thankful and grateful, that I am where I'm at. I am with the Lord. He's my shepherd, and I should not want. Sometimes I think, like a lot of the times when I go on these road trips to serve the Lord, I tell people that I'm going to be taking off, and they ask me, where are you going? I'm going to go serve the Lord, continue on preaching the good news, the gospel. And they ask me, where are you going with? Are you going with a church? And my answer is, I'm by myself. Well, never by myself, with Jesus, because he's always with me. I let him know, and it's a joy to walk by faith, to walk in the Spirit. I ask, I know a lot of brothers have their calling, and I respect that. God bless them. I rejoice that they're serving the Lord and answering to the calling. And I am aware also that there's brothers that are not willing to come out. And I ask them if they want to go, out on the road to other cities, other states, to share the gospel. They always oh, I ain't got no money. Oh, I can't. And always an excuse. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. So, it's like when the Lord calls me, like this time I came, I'm with another brother, and he's married now, and he's been a blessing in my life for the Lord. Very encouraging, very humble. He's a good man of God. And I was with him. And the Lord just put it in my heart to go. And I told him. And then this lady, she wanted me to help her. We were helping this lady on the staging company. She wanted me to work the next day. So I asked Michael if he could work. He we said yes, and I told a lady that that I couldn't work, that my brother Michael, that he was available, so that I was gonna take off. And you know, that was God's plan for my brother to help her out, and for me to be out here. You know, just the Lord put it in my heart. And next morning, I wake up early in the morning and I hit the road. So I needed to get a rest and, you know, prepare. Prepare just to get some rest, that's it, and fill up the gas tank. And like, I have nothing in this world that I could leave behind. Or I mean, I just got my belongings, my clothes, my preaching gear, and that's all I need. And when the Lord put it in my heart, you know, I was encouraged. And also my brother, he encouraged me. He's always encouraging me. So I love this brother. I love my brothers. And but there's some brothers that are always trying to put me down, you know, because they want me to go where they want me to go. They want me to preach where they want me to preach, when they want me to preach. But I have a calling from above, from God. He's my shepherd. He's leading me through the Spirit, and I'm thankful for that, because, you know, I broke down this time, and I was able to, you know, continue my journey. I was broken down, like, for 2 days, but God always made a way, and I'm here now. I'm refreshed, I'm thankful, I'm grateful that I am where I'm at. So that's the joy that I have in the Lord, that I gotta obey Him. I gotta obey the Spirit. And my other brothers that are never willing to come out, always putting excuses. I'm not pointing fingers, I'm just wanted to encourage you that trust in the Lord with all your heart. If God calls you to preach, to evangelize, to minister, to pray for people, because every time when I'm out on the road, I'm not just preaching. Wherever I'm at, whoever I'm talking to, of course, I gotta be the light. And I gotta bring Jesus to every conversation, bring the gospel, share a Bible tract in humility, in love, indeed. And just because I'm not out there preaching in Las Vegas or Seattle or wherever I'm at, you know, don't mean that I'm not in the Spirit, that I'm not doing the Lord's will, that I'm not walking by faith. Yeah, there's times that I need time alone, that I get attacked by the enemy. But if I'm on the road, you know, or if I'm wherever I'm at, I'm always sharing the good news, the Word of God. And I had a guy, well, I'm not even going to go there. I just asked God to enlighten his path. Yes, he attacked me a lot. So I erase his number now. And you know, I stay in the shelters. I stay in hotels when I can. I stay in my car. I stay in my tent. Or I stay with brothers sometime. And I'm not worried where I'm gonna sleep. I'm not worried what I'm going to eat. I'm not worried, you know, because I know that if we're on the Word, rooted on the foundation, that God will always provide. He will always make a way. So brothers and sisters, if you're if the enemy is putting doubt in your minds about that you don't have no money, that you don't have a place to raise your head, that you don't have food, if the enemy puts that in your mind, in your heart, I just rebuke in the name of Jesus. The Lord rebukes those negative thoughts. The Lord strengthen your mind. The Lord give you the desires of your heart as you delight in Him each day more and more. As you continue to seek Him daily, I just pray that His word will be engraved in your heart, in your soul and mind, and that you will not lack nothing, not nothing. That there will be no anxieties, no fear. I just pray that the Lord will guide you every step of the way. But you must trust in Him, for He loves you, He cares for you, and He wants to use you. He wants to use you, but you gotta be willing to do His work. When you do His work, He will do your work. You gotta do your part, He will do His part. So I pray for you right now, in the name of Jesus, amen. Wow. Praise the Lord, brothers and sisters. I'm just so happy to be here. I'm by myself with the Lord Jesus, because I'm happy. If I would be by myself, I wouldn't be happy, right? Amen. Hallelujah. So I wanna show you guys the back of this shirt. Yeah. And I just want you guys to know that it's not about me. It's not about me. And I don't, you know, it's not about, look what I'm doing, look what I could do. It's what God can do, what He's doing. So the life that I live now, I live by faith. And I walk by faith, not by sight. And, you know, so brothers and sisters, many are called, but few are chosen. Don't give up before your reward. Don't give up. Because Jesus is with you. He will never abandon us or forsake us. His grace, He loves us so much. Do we love Him? To obey Him? To trust in Him? Must be born again. Walk in the Spirit. And you would not desire the things of the flesh. But you must walk in the Spirit. You must deny yourself. You must humble yourself. So we all have a calling. We all have a calling from God Almighty, the Father. And I respect and I love my brothers and sisters that are out there in the Spirit, in truth, and in deed. And I don't judge them, you know, because they're not here with me. I don't judge them. You know, I love them. I love them. And I'm so happy that the words being advanced, and it's joy to know that my brothers and sisters are being led by God, by the Spirit of God. Just because they're not here with me, or, you know, I'm not going to be judging them. I'm not going to be pointing fingers. I'm not going to be, oh, you know, look at them. They're flying, or before I was in the bus, before I was in the train, you know, when I didn't have no car, I just got this car about a year ago. I just got my license, and God made a way. So just be patient. Be patient in the Lord. Trust in Him. Take your first step, step by step, you know, and trust in God, you know, just like Peter, you know, when Jesus was walking in water, you know, Peter wanted to go to Jesus. Jesus told him to come. What happened? He doubted when he was walking. He doubted. He feared. And what happened? He started sinking. So, brothers and sisters, if we have the faith the size of a mustard seed, we could tell this mountain to go into the sea, and it will do that. You know? I'm not saying let's put the Lord to the test. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying, let's love the Lord. Let's love Him and trust in Him, obey Him, and encourage one another daily. So, just give me a prayer, brothers and sisters. I'm expecting to get to Seattle on Tuesday and screening into a shelter. And, you know, because that's where the Lord has me. That's how I save up funds. I'm not a rich man. I'm on disability. And I help people out here and there. You know, and, you know, I don't have a, like people say, a church building that funds your trips. No, I don't have none of that. I don't have that. I have Jesus, and that's plenty. That's all I need, Jesus Christ. Love you, family. Thank you for giving me prayer. God has answered your prayers, and He is answering your prayers. So, stay strong in the Lord. Don't fear this world. Don't fear man. But fear God. Fear God. Love you. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. Isn't that awesome?
Rejoice in the Lord. Good morning. Morning, sunshine. Rise and shine and give God the glory. For He is good. He's an awesome God and He's coming soon. So, brothers and sisters, just look out there. It's nice, beautiful. So, I'm going to read a psalm right here. Psalm 103, for the glory of God, because I'm so blessed, so so blessed and thankful to be in the Lord. Not in the world, but in the Spirit. For I walk by faith, not by sight. Amen. Psalm 103. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is with me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul. And forget not all his benefits, who forgiveth all thy iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases, who redeemeth thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercies, who satisfieth thy mouth with good things, so that thy youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord executed righteousness and judgment for all that are oppressed. He made known his ways unto Moses, his acts unto the children of Israel. The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and plenteous in mercy. He will not always chide, neither will he keep his anger forever. He hath not dealt with us after our sins, nor rewarded us according to our iniquities. For as the heaven is high above the earth, so great is his mercy toward them that fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath he removed our transgressions from us. Like as a father pitied his children, so the Lord pitied them that fear him. For he knoweth our frame, he remembered that we are dust. As for man, his days are as grass. As a flower of the field, so he flourisheth. For the wind passeth over it, and it is gone, and the place thereof shall know it no more. But the mercy of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting upon them that fear him, and his righteousness unto children's children, to such as keep his covenant, and to those that remember his commandments, to do them. The Lord hath prepared his throne in the heavens, and his kingdom ruleth over all. Bless the Lord, ye his angels that excel in strength, that do his commandments, hearkening unto the voice of his word. Bless ye the Lord, O ye his hosts, ye ministers of his, that do his pleasure. Bless the Lord, O his works, in all places of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Wow. Praise him. Praise him. Praise the Lord. So that's King James Version. And if you guys are King James only, God bless you. I'm Jesus Christ only. And I'm going to read another translation. It's the Living Bible. So if you're King James only, go ahead and shut it off and rebuke me. 103, bless the holy name of God with all my heart. Yes, I will bless the Lord and not forget the glorious things he does for me. He forgives all my sins. He heals me. He ransoms me from hell. He surrounds me with loving kindness and tender mercies. He fills my life with good things. My youth is renewed like the eagles. He gives justice to all who are treated unfairly. He revealed his will and nature to Moses and the people of Israel. He is merciful and tender toward those who don't deserve it. He is slow to get angry and full of kindness and love. He never bears a grudge nor remains angry forever. He has not punished us as we deserve for all our sins. For his mercy toward those who fear and honor him is as great as the high of the heavens above the earth. He has removed our sins as far away from us as the east is from the west, he is like a father to us, tender and sympathetic to those who reverence him, for he knows we are but dust, and that our days are few and brief, like grass, like flowers blown by the wind and gone forever. But the loving kindness of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting to those who reverence him. His salvation is to children's children, to those who are faithful to his covenant and remember to obey him. The Lord has made the heavens his throne. From there he rules over everything there is. Bless the Lord, you mighty angels of his, who carry out his orders, listening for each of his commands. Yes, bless the Lord, you armies of his angels who serve him constantly. Let everything, everywhere, bless the Lord, and how I bless him too. Glory to God, glory to God. He's coming soon. He's coming soon. He's coming soon. Let's fear God. Let's fear God and do his will. Let's warn this generation of the rat that is coming. For if we love them, we will warn them of the truth. We will cleanse our hands of their blood. We will.
What a glorious God we serve. Elohim, El Shaddai, Adonai, Christ, Jesus, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Thank you for watching this video. Keep me in prayer. Keep me in prayer. And if you need prayer, let me know, and I'll be more than blessed to pray for you in the mighty name of Jesus. God bless. I'm gonna need a fire department.
What's up, Frank? What's going on? What's that right there, bro?
Praise and glory and honor be to God in the highest, for he is so worthy to be praised. It's a beautiful day that the Lord has made, rejoicing in the abundance and the blessings of God, for he is Jehovah Jireh, a God that provides. I just made it to Seattle, and by the grace of God and by your prayers, I was able to get here safe and be here enjoying this goodness of God, what he has provided. We got some sausages, and we got a, what kind of steak is this?
I don't know, some type of steak. T-bone or whatever.
Ribeye. It's a ribeye steak.
What else we got here? Yeah, chicken.
We got a T-bone steak. So we're going to go ahead and throw it in there. For I don't have a house because this is not my home. I'm just passing through, and this is my kitchen for right now. I'm about to enjoy this breakfast, and this is my brother Fernando here that I hadn't seen in a
hello
in some time. You know, I'm just catching up on things, fellowship, and just praising the Lord. We're two or more are gathered in God's mighty name. God is here. Yes, so God is here. Thank you, brothers and sisters. God bless. In Jesus' name.
God bless everybody.
In the morning, when I rise. In the morning, when I rise. In the morning, when I rise. Give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. You can have all this. this world. Just give me Jesus. When I am alone, when I am alone, oh, when I am alone, give me Jesus, give me Jesus, give me Jesus. You can have all this world, just give me Give me Jesus.